Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me, I have something special for us today, something we have never really looked at on Dotto Tech. Today, we are going to look into mind reading. No. No, that's not right. Mind mapping. That's what it is. Mind mapping. Today, on Dotto Tech. I am a big fan of the mind map. If you haven't played with mind maps before, this is what a mind map is. It is basically a hierarchical diagram that conveys a concept, an idea, a thought, a process, something like that. And now you might call it whiteboarding or spitballing or the sort of thing that you do on a napkin with your buddies as you're planning out your future. We all mind map one way or another, but now we have software, actually we've long had software, that formalizes the mind mapping process. But while mind mapping itself is a very simple concept, entrenching it into a piece of software can be a little bit more difficult. And now there's some very expensive solutions out there for mind mapping, but fortunately there's also some very free solutions out there for mind mapping, such as MindMup, which is what we're going to take a look at today. 100% free. Now you can actually spend maybe up to $20 a year or so on it if you buy the advanced version, which I will talk about. It really doesn't do anything that the simple version does, except it allows you to share your mind maps a little more easily. And plus, they also provide some storage for you. But the bottom line is, this is the software here that I use to create this little simple mind map is something that's available and accessible, and you should be trying out. You know, mind mapping is taught in a lot of school systems in the world. Germany, for example, they teach mind mapping to everybody. Now, they don't teach it in Canada, as far as I know, nor in the States. There's certainly university-level courses where they involve it, and it is something that we inherently do, but actually making it a formal part of the curriculum hasn't happened yet. But it would be well worth considering, personally, I think. So let's take a look at how the mind mapping software works, MindMup, in this particular case. You can go to mindmup.com, sign up for a free account, then you can access it through the web browser. You can also install a Chrome extension, which will allow you to run it through Chrome. You can save your maps in Dropbox or in Google Drive, and you can also there's also a desktop version that you can use for offline access. But for the most part, just go to the website and start playing with it. And the whole idea behind creating a mind map is to just empty your mind, to throw everything that you all the different ideas down onto the page, and then create a hierarchy out of it, create linkages between it. And you do that just by basically typing ideas and going along. So here I am, I'm just working on it. This is more just to give us an example, to have something in place, but I'm working on my thoughts around planning a webinar. I've been doing a lot of webinar planning type stuff lately. So here I am putting all of the different pieces together. Now, MindMup is designed by geeks for geeks. So everything that you can do from the keyboard. You can also have this little toolbar here that does everything that the keyboard does, but allows you to select it and be able to see exactly what happens. But basically what we've got is we've got, if we look at the relationship, is each of these little nodes here have siblings, which are other nodes which are at the same hierarchical level as them. And then they have children. They have child nodes that are related to them as well. And if you look at this, this is kind of a family tree, or they call it a subtree. So there are these relationships. It's all how things are related to each other in a workflow. And you can create workflows, or you can create information flows. You can find areas of opportunity. There's lots of different ways to view mind maps, but the visual representation of a process or a concept is awesome to have to be able to work with. It allows you to entrench ideas, it allows you to share ideas, and allows you to work through problems and to plan more effectively. So there's lots of different use cases for it. So if I'm going to, let me add something to this. So I'm working on a webinar here. I know what I'm doing is I'm working on, let's say I'm looking at the rundown right now. So here's where I put the rundown. So in the planning process, I've gone through, we have to have content, we need an outline, we're actually gonna need graphics and stuff with marketing materials we're gonna need. But here's the rundown, which we're going to need done for any webinar so that we can plan all everything else. We don't know how we're going to market it, how we're going to tell people about it, till we have a rundown done of all of the different content. So it starts with a welcome. We're going to set expectations. We're going to do a poll. Then it's going to be part one. Now, the way that we add child nodes or sub-nodes to a node like this, with the rundown, is just by hitting the Enter key. The Enter key will create a new one at the same level. Oh, actually, I made a mistake there. It'll make the new one at the same level as this. So it creates a sibling. So this would be sibling, sibling, sibling. So that's not what I wanted to do. What I wanted to do was hit a tab, and that creates a child. That's right. Tab creates one. Do you see how it's linked? So it's in the rundown, and it's going to be intermission as we start laying out the webinar. And I hit a tab again, and it creates a subcategory for the intermission. If I'd hit return, it would have created another one at the same level, which might be part two. Do you see how this is all coming together? So we have the ability to build out all of the different content this way. You can multi-select different nodes, so you can apply formatting and other things to them. For example, here, for some reason, we didn't get the right color, so now it's in the right color as the rest of them. So there we've got the ability to slowly build out the different ideas. You can attach graphics to any of these, and you can actually even kind of turn them into a to-do list if you choose to. So you've got the ability to lay out the mind map thusly. Now, every different piece of mind mapping software is going to create different opportunities and allow you to apply them in different ways. What they've done with MindMup is they're really trying to do two different things. One is, if we go into the view menu here, we've got something called the side pane that allows us to turn on measurements and storyboards. And this really speaks to the authors, what they want to do with a piece of software like this, because obviously it's an open canvas as far as what we can do, or a blank canvas, excuse me, as far as what we could do with mind mapping software. But they wanted to create a measurements tool so that we can apply values and we can keep score. So there's a lot of different things that can be done with that, as far as scheduling, as far as ordering, I'm going to use it as far as scheduling out the webinar. I'll show you the measurements in a moment. But they also thought that people might want to use it for storyboarding. So if you think about this as a hierarchical representation, so we've got all of the different elements, but if you were writing a book, or if you were writing a blog post and you're doing your research and putting all the different ideas down, then you want to create a narrative out of that that doesn't necessarily follow the hierarchical form, because storyboards don't. So they could also turn on a storyboard. So let's start with that, and then we'll go to measurements and show you how that works. The storyboard, if you just turn on the storyboard, what you can do is you can see I've already started with it. You can drag out different elements from the mind map itself, and then you can put them in order so that you can start to lay out a concept of a narrative, of a storyboard that you might be writing against. So here it becomes a nice research tool for preparing for any sort of document writing at all. I think even more interesting is this one here, which is where we go into the measurements. The measurements is so cool. I'm going to choose for the webinar here. Let me just clear this out of here because I was playing with it earlier. So I'm going to create a new measurement, and I'm going to call this a rundown of the webinar. Just bear with me for a second. I'm going to add that. And when I add that, all I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the rundown here, and I'm going to add all of the different pieces at the same level of the webinar. All of the different modules of the webinar, essentially. And then just see, we've got a little spreadsheet here. So we can say for the welcome, I want the welcome to be 3 minutes. For the setting expectations, I'm going to do 2 minutes. And you see what's happening in the bottom? It's totaling things up for me. I'm going to spend 2 minutes on the poll. I'm going to go down to the poll. I'm going to spend 2 minutes. I'm going to spend 15 minutes on part one. I'm going to spend 5 minutes on the intermission. I'm going to spend 15 minutes in part two. And how much time does that leave me? That's 42 minutes of my total hour of the webinar, and now that's been used up. So you can use it for creating these sort of calculations based on content within it. So this opens up a huge variety of different ways that you could use a program like MindMup. It's, as I say, 100% free. You go to mindmup.com. Get it. And what I encourage you to do is, with a program like this, just start to play with it. See where it fits in your life. If you like it, you can use it for as long as you want for free. If you decide that you want to do a little bit more with it, this is the more that you can do. Let me just toggle this off. Will that close it? There we go. Let me show you what I found really interesting. Is if we go into the share menu, because I've got the gold version, so I've got the $20 a year version, and it's based on how much storage you take up. And I think it would be hard to spend much more than that. I can take this and I can actually embed the HTML code from this into my own website. So you could create a mind map that you could then publish into your blog or onto your site using this. It gives you lots of opportunities for sharing it. You can also, of course, if we take a look in the sharing menu, you can tweet it out into social media or send it into Facebook. So you can take this idea, this map. And when you start thinking about the ability to add graphics to it and to be able to add different linkages using different colors, adding some titling to it, you could create a really nice description of a process with this tool and then be able to share it. Now, the reason that you need to get the premium version to share is you can save it in Google, in your Google Drive, in Google Drive, but it won't allow, Google's, by the nature of how Google Drive works, it doesn't allow you to share things directly out of that, so you can't share it directly out of that. And the same with Dropbox, is you don't have the HTML code, you don't basically have the web address to be able to share it. So you need to use this if you want to be able to share it. That's the prime reason that you might consider the premium version. Pretty cool, eh? I hope you like and give it a shot. And if you do create some cool mind maps, let me know. I'd love to hear what you use mind mapping for. That's a great use of the comments area here below. That's it for today. I hope you found it useful. There's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. First, subscribe to the channel. Secondly, subscribe to our newsletter. Then you'll hear about upcoming webinars that we do, like the ones that I'm planning here in my mind map. And finally, Dotto Tech is a crowdfunded site through the site Patreon. If you want to know what it's like being a Dotto Tech patron and what the perks are, because there are some awesome perks, I encourage you to visit our Patreon page. Well, that's it for today. I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.